Hi, I'm the rap critic.
And I'm Kyle Kalgren.
So you are.
So, you remember that time you randomly interrupted me on my show?
Yeah.
Well, your latest episode involves performance art and Marina Abramović, which is, my particular area of expertise.
Wait, you know about Jay-Z shooting a music video?
It was shot at the Pace Gallery and sold as a performance art piece. Of course I know it.
Well, I need you to explain a few things for me, because we all know who Jay-Z is on my show, but at the risk of making this sound like an A&E special, what exactly is the definition of performance art?
Well, performance art is difficult to define, but generally it's something performed by the artist themselves in a space for an audience. It's not like in theater, the performer plays themselves and not a role. It's not pretending, but doing. Often performance art tests the limits of the human body, the limits of society's taboos, and the limits of the relationship between artist and audience. Sometimes it's political, like Punk Prayer by Pussy Riot, where members of the band broke into the Cathedral of Christ the Savior in Moscow and began shouting, singing, and playing protest music. Or it could be personal, like the 1975 piece Interior Scroll, where the artist stood on a table, naked, and read aloud from a feminist discourse extracted from her vagina. And Seedbed by Vico Anconci, in which the artist hid under a false floor of an art gallery, wired up to a microphone, allowing his voice to be projected into the room as he vigorously masturbated. So, it takes a lot of guts to pull off.
Wow. Well, in that case, I think that, honestly, Jay-Z's too normal for performance art. I mean, the stuff you're describing is pretty crazy and challenging. Jay-Z has too much of a reputation to do anything challenging. He's a businessman who's rich beyond his wildest dreams. The only reason I can see that he would do something like this is simply because he can. I mean, the guy's been on the Forbes list for at least the last 5 years now, so, you know, who's going to stop him? But before we get into the music, I have to ask, who is this Marina Abramović?
Yes, Marina Abramović. The Serbian self-proclaimed grandmother of performance art. Her body of work is as much art as it is a decades-long game of suicidal truth or dare. She is the definition of pushing the limit. Some career highlights include 1977's Imponderabilia, in which Abramović and her romantic and artistic partner Ule stood naked on opposite sides of a narrow doorway. The audience, trying to get through the doorway, would have to turn sideways and squeeze past them both, touching nude male and female flesh.
Weird.
That was practically G-rated. Compare it to Rhythm 2. In that one, she took a pill used to treat catatonia, causing her to go into seizures as the audience watched. And when that drug wore off, she took a pill used to treat aggression in depressive people, causing her body to be completely immobile.
Holy crap!
And then her most famous performance, 1974's Rhythm Zero. In that famous display, she stood before a small audience, perfectly still. Around her were 72 objects, including a rose, a feather, honey, a whip, scissors, a scalpel, and a gun with a single bullet. The audience was allowed to do whatever they wanted with the objects and her body. At first, the audience was gentle, but as time passed, they became more aggressive. Her clothes were cut. Blood was drawn. One person in the audience tried to pull a gun on her, before another audience member pushed the gun away. And at the end of the performance, running for a total of 6 hours, she stood up and simply walked towards the audience. And they scattered, afraid to confront her.
Wow.
Okay, now before we get into—
Hey, dude, this art lesson is very endearing stuff, but I have to ask if this is leading up to a point, because we have to get to the music eventually.
I'm getting there. In 2010, Abramović did a piece at the Museum of Modern Art called The Artist is Present. There was a documentary made of it, check it out. The setup was quite simple. Abramović would sit motionless in a chair for hours upon hours as museum visitors, one by one, sat across from her as she stared at them. The results were shocking. Many visitors began to cry in her presence, deeply affected by her intense personal energy and silent charisma. One young woman tried to strip naked in front of her before being escorted out by security.
Damn, she got a chick to strip for her without saying a word. Now that's some charisma for your ass.
Think that's impressive? A lot of them tried to propose. She somehow managed to convince them that she had fallen in love on the spot.
So, how does this relate to the Picasso baby video?
Well, apparently Jay-Z saw that documentary too. And he was so moved by Abramovic's stamina and charisma and habit of putting herself into incredible, unthinkable danger that he decided to honor her artwork by rapping over a long period of time to regular people. Well, if by regular people you mean art world insiders ranging from Abramovic herself to Diana Whitmire Picasso. Picasso. As in Picasso's actual baby.
So this artistic performance wasn't available to the public, just a select few?
Yeah, like some fans got in, but mostly it was artists and art dealers.
That seems very un-hip-hop of him. Wouldn't someone who rose from the streets want to allow any common man the ability to see rap music recognized and treated with the same respect as artists of other mediums?
Who cares? Photo op with Jim Jarmusch! Not only that, he cheated. He rapped for 6 hours, plus water breaks. Abramovic didn't even get up to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, but why does it ultimately matter, though? He just did this as a way to set up the music video.
Because The Artist Is Present is about the role of the artist in relation to the audience, an ego-driven exercise demonstrating the role charisma plays in the dynamic. The banality of seeing the artwork set against the strangeness of confronting the artists themselves. How many common visitors to MoMA could have sat next to Warhol or Van Gogh? Jay-Z seems to understand this relationship only superficially, so he recreates it by doing his own art, rapping, over a long period of time to a group of rich people he knows that he would look good next to.
So you're saying this whole music video is a setup for someone who wants to let you know about his awareness of an art form without actually demonstrating that they understand the point of it?
In short, yes.
That does not bode well for this song.
I just want a Picasso in my casa.
So at the very start, he proclaims, I just want a painting from a very famous artist in my house. What was that thing I said Jay-Z was again?
Someone who wants you to know about his awareness of an art form without actually demonstrating that they understand the point of it.
Oh yeah, but I think there's a shorter way to say that.
I'm an asshole.
Well, I was gonna say pretentious, but okay.
I'm never satisfied, cannot my hustle. I want a brothel. No, I want a brothel.
First, your line of thinking leads you to want to get a painting, and then it randomly leads you to wanting to go to a whorehouse? I don't think never satisfied is the same thing as supremely indecisive.
Let's make love on a million in the dirty hotel with the fan on the ceiling.
I see he went with the brothel option.
All for the love of drug dealing,
All for the love of drug dealing? I'm sorry, whatever happened to showing drug dealing as a means to an end that you're ashamed about? Like on Regrets, where you were talking about selling opium in third person because you didn't want to face the reality of what your customers were going through. Or on all of your songs since your first album, when you were obviously not selling drugs anymore, where you said you weren't glorifying drugs, but merely reminiscing and looking back on your drug dealing days for the purpose of giving voice to those still stuck in that grind. Now you claim that it wasn't for the profit that eventually gave you access to a less dangerous career choice, but that you sold drugs all for the love of drug dealing, like it's some sport that you really have to have your heart in order to succeed? That's stupid.
Oh, what a feeling. Fuck it, I want a billion.
I'm pretty sure this is supposed to be the oh snap moment of the song, with the music dropping out and everything, but he didn't really say anything profound or clever. Maybe this is the line everyone's supposed to shout when he points the mic at the crowd, but all I can think of when I hear this is some fat cat CEO at McDonald's giving himself a pay raise.
Well, since we are one of the richest companies in the world, I suppose I could give myself a lot more money. Or I could give a raise to the millions of people who work for me at minimum wage.
Fuck it, I want a billion!
Meh, screw 'em.
Jeff Corn balloons, I just want to blow up.
Oh hey, a reference to an artist's work. But since Jeff Koons balloons aren't actual balloons, but stainless steel statues, the wordplay referring to them blowing up, doesn't kind of, sort of, really work?
Bacon, some turkey bacon, smelly aroma.
Is this Jay-Z trying to be clever? Because it's not so much wordplay as it is just an acknowledgement that yes, Francis Bacon was an artist, and yes, bacon is strips of meat.
It ain't hard to tell. I'm the new Jean-Michel.
Okay, that's not a bad comparison. Jean-Michel Basquiat is another African-American New York native who struggled from nothing to fame using a form of expression popular in inner cities.
Really now? Huh. Makes me wonder why he didn't name the song after him.
Not as famous as Picasso.
Oh yeah.
Sleeping every night next to Mona Lisa. The modern day version with better features.
You know, the woman in the Mona Lisa isn't necessarily known for her beauty. In fact, she's pretty plain, even by 16th century standards. What's important about the work is how she's set against a beautiful but geographically impossible background, how her famously indecipherable smile suggests so much about the subject's personality. If you want to compare your woman to something, you know, archetypically beautiful, then why not, My Lady's the Venus. Every night, sleeping with a Botticelli.
Because he doesn't seem to study pieces as much as he blindly collects them like Pokemon cards. I mean, from what I can tell, he doesn't give a crap about the actual preservation of the art itself. Look at lines like this.
Yellow Basquiat in my kitchen corner. Go ahead, lean on that shit, Blue, you own it, huh?
Yes, Blue Ivy, Jay-Z's daughter. Lean on those paintings Daddy just paid a fortune for. Go ahead, nibble and drool on them as well. People now know that I have the millions of dollars that it takes me to get these intricate models of inner-city angst and turmoil, so now they no longer serve a purpose. Oh, who's adding some more yellow to that Basquiat painting? Who's adding some more yellow to that Basquiat painting?
It's funny because Andre Serrano is in the crowd. Someone's gonna get that. Someone has to get that.
I never stuck my cock in the fox's box, but damn if I ain't open Pandora's box.
What?
I think he's referring to Foxy Brown? She was his protege from the late 90s, and maybe he's alluding to the fact that he never had sex with her, but I'll be damned if I can tell you what that has to do with this song. Or why he felt that was appropriate to start the third verse with.
They try to slander your man on CNN and Fox. My Mirandas don't stand a chance with cops.
Talking about problems with the law and how the media doesn't understand your struggle, this just sounds like a lost verse from 99 Problems.
Even my old fans like, oh man, stop.
Well, that's because your old fans noticed that you pretty much said everything you needed to say after the first time you claimed you were going to retire. After your first album, Reasonable Doubt. Of course, then there was the second time you said you were going to retire. After your third album, Volume 2, Hard Knock Life. And then there was the third time you said you were going to retire with the Black Album. You know, now that I look at it, you were the one who kept telling yourself to stop.
I'm still the man to watch Hublot.
You know, saying that this is like the third time that I've heard you mention Hublot watches in a song, this is starting to just sound like product placement.
Well, don't rappers mention product placement a lot nowadays?
Yeah, but he's talking about a watch. People may not buy True Religion jeans, but at the very least, they buy jeans. Nobody buys watches anymore, so this name drop just sounds blatantly paid for.
Soon as I step by the booth, the cameras pop. Niggas cool with it till the cannons pop.
I think this is like the first clever play on words in this song. Mixing cameras flashing with cannon shooting, which is indeed the name of a camera company and a hyperbolic representation of a powerful gun.
That's nice. Wasn't this rap about art?
My hair pin, pale skin, ruptured spleens, cracked ribs, go through cribs and other things.
Yes, more of these lyrics that are only detailing your gangster history and totally not glorifying it.
No sympathy for the king, huh? Niggas even talk about your baby crazy.
Seriously, are we still talking about art? Because it seems like you've given up on the art puns a little soon, don't you think? Like bacon and eating bacon, condos in the condos, and that's it?
Yeah, Jay-Z, if you're gonna do this, go all out like your verse in Back in the Days when you made a whole bunch of hit or miss references to hip-hop artists. Screw it, let's do it for him.
Yo, sleeping with my own little Venus, but the modern version with better features.
Yeah, that's my Botticelli.
You must be making the sandwich cause I know you're getting jelly.
She my canvas, the eagle is my wallet.
So when I'm splashing money on her, call me Jackson Pollock. I'm all about my cheddar and art though.
So it's Monet, Cash and Hoes.
Jose Orozco, with my rivals and brothels, I'm surrounded by fair faces cause I got more than two nudes descending my staircases. So don't disrespect, think you're richer, you wanna bet? Well that's a bet you're going to lose.
Latrec.
Now let's stop pretending to be hardcore gangsters and let Jay-Z do that for us.
Come through with the yay mask on, spray everything like Sambo, I won't scratch the Lambo.
Really, Jay-Z? You're gonna personally kick doors off the hinges and start a shooting spree? While your music video takes place in a safe, comfy art museum as you get chummy with the likes of Alan Cumming and Judd Apatow?
Well, we don't believe you, you need more people. What's it gonna take for me to go?
As in, what would it take for you to leave? Well, that would require you retiring and then not coming back.
For you to see, I'm the modern day Pablo Picasso, baby.
Oh, wait. So what you're saying is, what would it take to make people see you as a modern-day Picasso, but one who paints pictures with his words? Well, a good way to do that would have been using this song to point to your past works like Reasonable Doubt or The Black Album, to talk about how you've given us classic rap albums that will stand the test of time as artistic depictions of your psyche in that time period of your life. However, as this song stands, it does nothing of the sort. So for a pretty nice beat, but pretty lazy lyrics, I'd give it a 3 out of 5. And as for the video we just watched, honestly, was that it? All the buildup for a classy high art video for nothing more than Jay-Z in a white room rapping one song to his rich friends? And now that I think about it, these people just sat through a 6-hour concert in which they've only heard one song. I don't care if it is at a museum, that sounds like a ripoff.
You know, it bothers me that this performance was done specifically for the music video. Sure, there's nothing against performance art being documented. The photographs of early Abramovic performances are invaluable. However, it's fully understood that the photographs and the video are not the performance. The artists present may have commented on that. Sure, there was a documentary and it captured many different reactions to the performance, but it's tangential to the act itself. Jay-Z is making and selling a product. His work is also ego-driven, but in the more self-serving sense. Abramovic has had critics accuse her of much the same, selling her work on the Abramovic brand. Hell, just look at what she's been doing with Lady Gaga lately. But here, Jay-Z's ego and ambitions are hardly dissimilar from his earlier ego and ambitions. That is to say, money, cash, hoes. Only here his hoes are Picasso, Koons, Rothko, and Basquiat. He's not rapping about their art, or what they aim to do with their art. He's rapping about owning their art, and being seen owning their art. This rap is the dictionary definition of pretentious.
So we just spent this whole video relaying the message that Jay-Z is an unabashed pretentious asshole?
Yep.
Yeah, I'm cool with that.